Hi, welcome to UiPath RPA tutorial. In this lesson, I will explain what the dynamic selector is and show you how we use dynamic selector in UiPath. So first of all, I want to explain what the dynamic selector is or why we need that. Let's say you will go into academy site and you need to get all the names of the courses. So you need to take all the names from this site. When you are getting the names, you cannot specify the selector for this manner. So you have to define dynamic selector for each of the courses, and then you will be able to get the names of the courses from this site. So let's have a look with UI Explorer. Let's say I want to get the name of first course, it's RPA solution architecture. If I want to get the name of this course, I need to use this selector, but there is a AA name, which means the name of this element, and I cannot use it because it will be changeable from course to course, right? So I need to find another selector without AA name, and I need to make it dynamic so that I can be able to get all the course names from the academy site. So for this action, first of all, I need to remove AA name. Then I will add parent class, for example. It says IDX1. So I am thinking that it would be possible to use this selector, and I can also expect that it will be incremental, like 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. So that if it is getting the first course name, if I change it to 2, I will take the second course name. If I change it to 3, I should take third course name, and etc. So let's try it. First of all, let's see it. Okay, that's okay. After that, I will change it to, and it finds RPA toolkit. So if I say 5 here and 5th courses is here, continue, let's say 7 and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7th course. So let's say I will take the first 10 courses. I am going to need for each loop for that, and I need to dynamically change the selector to be able to get these course names from the screen, right? So let's do that. This is my selector. So here, first thing first, I need to assign my base selector, JTLK base selector, enter, then expression, this is it. Let me plus this and this. So I need to play with this area to be able to make it dynamic. If it is the first one, it should be 1. For the second one, it should be 2, and so on so forth. So I need to change it to the variable so that I can use it for my for each loop. So I will delete it and define a variable, dynamic selector IDX. Okay, let me check it. It's here. So for each, before that, I need to open browser. Let me also show you that. I will open the Edge browser with this URL. I will change it my browser type to Edge, and after that I will get text from screen with using with my dynamic selector. So another assignment here, and I will use it for getting my dynamic selector. Let's say we will need to get first 10 course names from the screen, so I will need a loop for that, and I will use while loop for that. Let me get it here. So to be able to use while loop, I need to set condition and define the counter, and I will count up to 10, and for each step I will get the course name from screen. So for that I will get assign jtlk counter max and let it be 10. Let me change it to integer, and also I need to define the counter itself and let it be 1, because my IDX value starts with 1. I am going to use that, so let me change it to integer. And after that I need to define the condition counter lower than counter max. Okay, so first thing first, I need to increase counter for each step, counter plus 1. Let me delete this. And after that I am going to get the selector value. Let me use assignment again. Before the counter assignment, I need to perform my steps. So let me assign dynamic selector IDX my counter to string. So it will be 1, and then my base selector contains dynamic selector IDX, so it will change to IDX1, and after that it will change to IDX2, IDX3, and so on and so forth. Let's use get text, and I will show you to the output of this activity. I am going to write my selector here, dynamic selector base, sorry, base selector. So the output value jtlk course name, and after that let us log it, log message and info course name counter to string concatenation. I need to use this. Okay, and after that it will finish this activity, this do while loop, and it will write to log message as our courses here. Hopefully let's run it and see the results. I need to close this. It is opening the courses page on UiPath Academy, and it is getting first 10 course name from the screen, and it will write it to as log message. I think it's done. No, it's working still. Let's examine this. For this time I will go with debug file so we can see what is going on. Debug file, close. And let's see. Base selector. IDX seems to be empty. Dynamic selector IDX is 1. Ah, okay, I got it. So after that I also need to reassign this JTLK dynamic selector, and let's write here this one dynamic selector. So I think this time it will work. Let's see. Run file. Let me close this one. Let's see what is inside of our dynamic selector. Dynamic selector. Yes, it's like that. So continue. Let me toggle that, continue. And it finished working. Let me check. As you can see here, I put less than equal. I should put like that. That's why we see 9 elements here. RPA solution architecture fundamentals, RPA toolkit, blah 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 blah. First 9 courses here, and let's take a look here. 9th course is process analysis advanced with UiPath process mining, and here also, is it the same? Yeah, as you can see here, we have used dynamic selector to be able to get course names from UiPath Academy. Mainly, if you need to get the names or text from the screen, and if you are dealing with the list as seen here, you probably will need dynamic selector. You can use it in this way. And that will be all. Thank you for watching.